My name is Raquel Domenici. I teach foods and nutrition here at South Davis Junior High. And today we have been finishing up gingerbread houses that they have built. They made the dough, they rolled it out, they cut them, and they've been putting them together, and they brought their own candy, so it's a creative endeavor. It uses their cooking skills, their getting along skills, their planning. We could even add some interior design in there with color schemes if you really want to go that far. And so it's something that I've done as a family tradition since I can remember. And I don't honestly know. I called my mom and asked her where she got the recipe and the ideas. She's like, well, I don't know. We've been doing it forever too.
Hi, I'm Daniel. And today we've just been making gingerbread houses. I've just always had like a picture ever since we started making it of what it will look like. I've always kind of liked architecture, so I wanted to make the dormers. So I cut out some gingerbread pieces for that. And then I made the icicles, and I don't know, I just kind of kept adding on until I was satisfied. Actually, I didn't realize how weird it is to make gingerbread. It's like a lot thinner than normal bread. It's like a cookie, but I guess that's implied.
It's like watching them actually decorating them and getting different ideas and how they ask each other what to do and do you think this looks good? And I like how they help each other. That's fun. The most difficult part is definitely the rolling out and the cutting part. So you want to roll the dough out before you cut it. Roll it out on in a baking sheet about 1/4 inch thick, and then you cut it out immediately after taking it out of the oven. That way the pieces don't bake strange or you have them change shape when you try to move the shape from the counter where you've rolled it and cut it to the baking sheet. Because we were frustrated for a really long time with the pieces that didn't fit quite right and how they just weren't working together. And this was an idea that came from my Aunt Lois, and my great aunt actually. And so she showed us how to do it this way, and I've been doing it that way ever since. It's been 35 years.
Hi, I'm Isabel. I'm a 9th grader at South Davis Junior High. My favorite part of making gingerbread houses would be just decorating them and doing your own thing and making your own design. I learned that you can like be yourself and express who you are like through really whatever you like choose to do. So like through the decorating, you can just express like who you are and like what you kind of like to do and stuff.
I really liked the thatched roof with the shredded wheat. I had never seen that before. Really fun. Some of them were doing things with the food coloring as well, and they didn't even mix it with frosting. They just kind of dumped it on and let it run. I've never done that before either. So that was creative, definitely, though not something I would have thought of.